Hello everyone, in today's class we are going to form a regular expression from a given automata. So we follow the Kleene's theorem for this procedure, and there is a specific way in which we have to form the regular expressions for any of the DFA transitions. So we'll see the theorem which actually explains the procedure of conversion. So first of all, there is an assumption that if there is a DFA A with some language which is accepted by this automata A, then there is a regular expression R that accepts the same language. So therefore, the language which is accepted by the DFA should be same as the language which is defined by the regular expression. Now once we have known this, let's write a simple DFA here. So suppose you have a simple DFA. So maybe this is the DFA and we write A and B here. So if this is the DFA given to us, we have to form the regular expression for this DFA. So there is A and there is B. So as soon as you start from the start state, you know that you have A which is getting accepted. So we write A as the regular expression and it is immediately followed by a B. So the regular expression which is accepted by this machine is nothing but AB. So likewise, we have to form a generalized method of identifying the regular expressions from the automata transitions. So here, for this purpose, we take R of ij. So R represents regular expression and ij represents the transition between I and j, where k is the number of intermediate states between this I and j. So before that, we start with the basis step. In the basis step, we consider that I and j are two states and there are no intermediate states between I and j. So therefore, we write k is equal to 0. So k is equal to 0 states that between the state I and between the state j, there are no intermediate states. So what are the three cases for which we can form two states with no intermediate states? Okay, so first one is, this is the first case where this is the state I and this is the state j, and this is the case where I is not equal to j. That means I is a separate state and j is a separate state. Next is, we may have a single state and a loop, and I just write I here. So that means this is the case where there is a transition from one state to another state, but that another state happens to be the same state. So that means you are leaving from one state and going back to the same state. So this is the case where the source I is equal to the destination j. So these are the two things that are possible when our k is equal to 0. In this case, let us find out how to form the regular expressions for the different transitions. Now we'll take the first case. In case the automata is a representation as something like this, where you have the state I and then you have the state j, and there is no transition between this I and j. So there is all possibility that there could be some states between which we don't have any transitions at all. So in that case, our regular expression that we write for such kind of transition is nothing but a null. So no transition, no input symbol, therefore we just write a null. Second case is, we have a I and then we have a destination j. So all these are cases where we don't have any intermediate states. And suppose there is a single input symbol A on the transition. Then for such kind of transitions, the regular expression that we write is nothing but a single A, which is there on the transition. So the third kind of transition that might exist between this I and j is, we may have n number of symbols. So I'll call the first symbol as A1, comma A2, comma A3, up to some AK. So We know that while writing the DFA transitions, there could also be a possibility that it's not just restricted to a single input symbol. There could be multiple input symbols on the transition. That means from I to J, we can move either on A1 or on A2 or on A3 or any of them up to AK, but only one at a time, not all at a time. So therefore, if you have any transitions of this kind, then we have to frame the regular expression as a regular expression is equal to A1 or A2 or A3 up to some AK. So A1 or A2 or A3 or A4 up to some AK. So these are the types of transitions that we are going to encounter and the corresponding regular expressions that we are going to write for such transition. And all of these are taking into consideration that there are no intermediate states between I and J, that is the source and destination. So we can see that all of this is a case where I is not equal to J. So all of these we wrote for the case where I is not equal to J. I is a separate state and J is a separate state. So for the same K is equal to 0, there could be another possibility, that is nothing but having the loop. So we'll take up the second case where you have a loop. So whenever we are considering any loop, we have to go on adding epsilon for those regular expressions. So for the first regular expression, if I take up, it is going to be null plus epsilon. The second regular expression is going to be A plus epsilon. And the third regular expression is going to be A1 or A2 or A3 up to or AK plus epsilon. So this is the way in which we are going to treat the loops and the states which are different from each other. So this is just the basis step where we have considered K is equal to 0. So one more thing that we have to understand here is we have basically just written RE is equal to RE is equal to RE is equal to. So this is only for the understanding. The formal notation that we are going to write in every place is this is the regular expression R between the state I and J. So this is the regular expression between the state I and J. We are going to write the number of intermediate states here in place of K. So it is going to be 0. We don't have any intermediate states. So similarly for the rest of them also, this is R of IJ when there are no intermediate states. Again, this is R of IJ and there are no intermediate states. So the same thing over here, the regular expressions to be more specific is nothing but R of IJ to the power of 0, then R of IJ to the power of 0, then R of IJ to the power of 0. So this is how we represent the regular expressions. So once we finished with the basis step, we'll move ahead and see what is the induction step. So in the induction step, we take some K which is equal to 1. So between this I and J, there is some K as a intermediate state. So these are the cases where we framed for no intermediate states. So here we are going to find out how to form the regular expression in case there is some intermediate state K. So here there are two ways in which, so I am going to write a loop on this K just to tell you that there could be n number of intermediate states. So instead of writing the n number of intermediate states, we can just put a loop on it saying that it can have any number of symbols in between this I and J symbols. So I, K and we have J. So we'll take case 1 where we consider that from I we are going to J without considering this k, because it is a loop on k. So you have to treat this as star. So star is nothing but zero or more occurrences. So therefore, first case we'll consider that we are moving from I to j, but we are not considering k in between. It does not pass through k. So therefore, the regular expression is given by r of ij of k minus 1. So I to j we are moving and we don't have any intermediate states. So therefore, we take this as k minus 1. Next, in case 2, we consider that we are going or passing through the state k to move to j. So therefore, I can write this as I followed by I'm going to k, then second time I'm going to k, third time I might go to k, and then only reach this j. So the meaning of writing multiple k's here is, for every time the k is receiving any input, I am writing that, splitting up and writing that k as many times as it is receiving the input. So now, in case if we want to go from I to j, so that means first I have to pass through I to k. First I have to go from I to k. So this is again k minus 1 intermediate states. Then from k to k, so r of k to k of k minus 1. Then here this path is also again from r, starting from k, ending at k. So r of kk whole to the power of k minus 1. Then at last it is k to j. So it is a path going from kj of k minus 1. So now what you can see here in this entire thing is, as many times as you are receiving the input on the state k with the loop, that many number of k's can come. So therefore, I can put a star here saying that it is n number of repetitions. So therefore, the expression will become r of ik whole to the power of k minus 1, r of kk whole to the power of k minus 1 whole star, then r of kj whole to the power of k minus 1. So in order to reach from I to j, whenever there is a intermediate state, there are two ways of reaching. So first one is directly from I to j with k minus 1 intermediate state, and the second way of reaching is I to k, k minus 1, but again by receiving n number of inputs at k and then going from k to j. So therefore, the final expression will become, so r of ij with k intermediate states is equal to r of ij of k minus 1, or the second path. So this is the second path. So r of I k, k minus 1, r of kk of k minus 1 the whole star, then r of kj k minus 1. So this is the final expression when we are going to choose, when we have n number of intermediate states between that I and j. So to wrap up, we will see here, when there are no intermediate states between this I and j, okay, so these are the three cases. One, without the transition. In case there is no transition between one state and another state, then the regular expression is going to be a null. When there is a single symbol on the transition, the entire regular expression is going to be a single symbol. Then when there are multiple symbols, it's a union, which is also represented as a plus. So that means it is the first symbol or the second symbol or the third symbol up to the last symbol. In case we are dealing with the loops, so this is the case where we are dealing with I equal to j. So whenever there is a transition where the transition is going from this state to the same state, then we add the epsilons to the transition that we have already identified. Next is when we have some intermediate state. So it's not necessary that we always choose the intermediate state, because we have represented it as I and then you have K. So there is a loop on this K and then you have the destination state J. So since this is a loop on the K, it is zero or more occurrences. So that means there are two ways of again reaching from I to J. One is by considering for moving through the K. The second condition is we are not accepting anything here and moving from I to J. So here if you are moving from I to J, the regular expression is denoted as R of ij of k minus 1. In case if you choose to go through this K, there can be any occurrences that we accept at K. So this is the regular expression. So for the automata which has got some intermediate state, there are two ways of reaching. The first way is this one. So we have written that expression here. Or this is the second way of reaching. So or, and then we have the second expression here. So once we know all these expressions, we can solve the problem in order to derive the regular expression. So now let's look at the problem. So we'll have to make sure that we remember all the expressions which are there on the board. So now we will look at the problem here. So they have given us a DFA and where they have asked us to form the regular expression from this DFA, and we'll be using the Kleene's theorem that we learned now. So the first thing that we do once we receive the problem is change the naming of the states to 1 and 2. So continuously number the states starting from 1 and up to n, depending upon how many number of states are there in that DFA. So we'll have to remember everything that we have written there. So first thing is we'll take k is equal to 0. So this is a basis step that we are performing. In the basis step we take k is equal to 0. So we'll write down what are the different paths which are possible when k is equal to 0. The different paths are r of 1 1 of 0, r of 1 2, r of 2 1 and r of 2 2. When k is 0, everywhere to the power of k is going to be 0, because the general expression is r of ij to the power of k. So we'll go on writing the expressions or the regular expressions for each one of them. Okay, so the possible transitions are 1 1 1 2 2 1 2 2. So depending upon what they are, we are going to write their expressions. So take up r of 1 1. So this is a loop. So as soon as you consider the loop, you should know that for whatever expression we have to add the epsilon. So r of 1 1 is there. So r of 1 2 1, it is the regular expression is single symbol which is equal to 1. Then since it is a loop, I am also going to add a epsilon. Next, r of 1 2. So r of 1 2 where I not equal to j. So this condition. So r of 1 to 2, there is a single symbol which is 0. So it is this case. So we are going to write that symbol 0, and we no need of adding the epsilon because it is I not equal to j condition. Next is r of 2 1. So 2 to 1. Can you see that there is no arrow mark going from 2 to 1? So this is this case where we don't have any transitions between the two states. Therefore, the regular expression is going to be a null. Next is r of 2 2. So r of 2 2, there are two symbols, 0 comma 1. So this is this case. And also since this is a loop, we are going to consider this case. So when there are two symbols, we write 0 or 1, and since it is 2 2, so the destination is also same, source is also same, so therefore we write the epsilon symbol. So this is how we frame the regular expressions for the basis step that we learnt here in these steps. So next we will move to taking up k is equal to 1. So k is equal to 1 and further we are going to use the expression that we have written there. So for k is equal to 1, first we will take up r of 1 1 of 1. So because k is equal to 1, here k is equal to 0, so we have written 0. Here k is equal to 1, so we write 1. So we will take up the generalized expression first, that is nothing but r of ij whole to the power of k minus 1 plus r of ik whole to the power of k minus 1 multiplied by r of kk to the power of k minus 1 the whole star, then r of concatenated with r of kj to the power of k minus 1. So we'll make the substitution here. So here I value is equal to 1, j value is also equal to 1, and k value is equal to 1. So I is equal to 1 here, then j is also equal to 1, and then we have k is also equal to 1. So we'll make the substitutions in the expression, general expression that we have written here. So that is nothing but r of 1 1 to the power of k minus 1 is nothing but 0. So that is 1 minus 1, 0, plus r of ik, so again 1 1 to the power of 0. Then next we have r of kk, again 1 1 to the power of 0 whole star. Next we have r of kj, so k and j, so k and j, 1 1 to the power of 0. So we can see that these expressions, whatever we have, can be taken up from the previous steps that we have already calculated. So substitute r of 1 1 of 0 is nothing but 1 plus epsilon plus r of 1 1 of 0, so that is nothing but again 1 plus epsilon, then 1 plus epsilon whole star, 1 plus epsilon. Now it's not sufficient for us if you just keep this as it is. We have to learn about few expressions that will allow us to simplify the larger expression, and those expressions are, so the some of the expressions that we have here will allow us to easily simplify the given larger expressions. So we can see here epsilon plus r the whole star is equal to r star. So r star also includes this epsilon. So there is no need to again write epsilon plus r the whole star. Next is r plus r star. So this is nothing but r or r star. So the r star itself can include this r also as well as r star also. So therefore it's enough if you write just r star. Anything that is concatenated with a null will always become null. Same thing happens here, it is identity, r plus null or null plus r does not affect the r, so therefore it is remains as r. Next is epsilon plus r whole star is equal to r star. So that means this r star also includes epsilon, also includes r star, so therefore it is r star. R into r star is equal to again r star, because r concatenated with r star is nothing but, at least there is one occurrence, after that you will have many occurrences. The same thing can be accepted by r star also. So here when you come and try to simplify the expression, this is 1 plus epsilon plus 1 plus epsilon the whole star, 1 plus epsilon, 1 plus epsilon, everything can be combined and formed into 1 plus epsilon whole star. So 1 plus epsilon or 1 plus epsilon the whole star. Okay, so this can be nothing but 1 plus epsilon the whole star. This again can just be 1 star, because epsilon is also included for 1 star. So this is the final expression that we derive for r of 1 1 of 1. So next we will pick up r of 1 2 of 1. So r of 1 2 of 1, so we will write the expression first. So here I is equal to 1, then we have j is equal to 2, and then we have k is equal to 1. So we will substitute in the expression. So these are the things that we have to note. So r of ij So r of I j to the power of k minus 1 will be 0 plus r of I and k. So I and k will be 1 1 to the power of 0. Then r of kk will be 1 1 again to the power of 0 whole star, and r of kj, so k and j, will be 1 and 2 to the 0. So from the previous step we have to substitute here. So r of 1 2 is nothing but 0 plus r of 1 1 is 1 plus epsilon. Then we have 1 plus epsilon the whole star. Then r of 1 2 is nothing but 0, concatenated with 0. So this is nothing but 0 plus 1 plus epsilon whole star 0. So which is nothing but 1 plus epsilon whole star 0. So this can be written as 0 or 1 star 0. Why 1 star? Because 1 star also includes this epsilon. So directly this entire expression can be written as 1 star 0. So this again can be just written as 1 star 0, because in case we don't accept anything for 1 star, so this 0, whatever we are not writing in this next step, can be accepted here. So therefore we can just write it as 1 star 0. So next we'll take up r of 2 1 of 1. So if we take r of 2 1 of 1, again we'll make the substitutions. So I is equal to 2, j is equal to 1, because I is equal to 2 and j is equal to 1, and also k is equal to 1. So we'll make the substitutions here. So r of ij, so 2 1 of 0 plus r of ik, so again 2 1, ij is 2 1 and ik, yes, it is also 2 1 of 0. Then r of kk, so it will be 1 1 of 0 plus, rather concatenated with, r of kj, so k and j, so it is 1 1 of 0. So we'll make the substitution. R of 2 1 is nothing but a null, plus r of 2 1 is again a null. Then r of 1 1 star is nothing but 1 plus epsilon the whole star. Then again r of 1 1 of 0, so r of 1 1 of 0 is nothing but 1 plus epsilon. So we see that r concatenated with a null will be equal to a null. So this is null plus null, which is equal to a null. So this is how we solve it. Okay, so next we will take up r of 2 2 to the power of 0. So once we take 2 2 to the power of 0, I is equal to 2, j is equal to 2, and also k is equal to 1. So we'll make the substitutions here. R of ij, so it is 2 2 to the power of 0, because this is k minus 1, plus r of, then you have ik, so I and k, so 2 and 1 to the power of 0. Then you have r of kk, so r of kk is r of 1 1 to the power of 0 whole star concatenated with r of kj, so k and j, 1 and 2, so 1 and 2 to the power of 0. So we'll make the substitution. So r of 2 2 is 0 plus 1 plus epsilon plus of 2 1 is a null, and then 1 1 is a 1 plus epsilon the whole star. Then r of 1 2 is a 0. So null concatenated with anything is going to be a null. So therefore the final expression is going to be 0 plus 1 plus epsilon. So now we have finished everything from 0 to 1. So we'll see here, there are n number of states. So there are 2 states here. So that means n is equal to 2. So therefore we have to solve the problem up to k is equal to n minus 1. After we have solved for k is equal to n minus 1, so that means we have finished for k is equal to 1. So the next step is to find out the final expression, that is nothing but r of ij of an. So here, so the final regular expression is given by r of ij to the power of n. So here I and j is the start state and j is the final state, and n is nothing but the number of states in the DFA. So that means we are now trying to frame r of 1, 2 to the power of 2, because there are 2 states, so n is equal to 2, start state is 1 and the final state is 2. So if you take up this and substitute in the same expression there, so we get r of, this is I is equal to 1, j is equal to 2 and k is equal to 2. So therefore r of 1 and 2 to the power of k minus 1, so that is going to be a 1. Then plus r of I k, so I and k, so 1 and 2 to the power of 1, so r of k k, so that is 2 2 to the power of 1 whole star. Then next we have r of k j of k minus 1, so r of k j is nothing but r of 2 2 of 1. So we have found out all the results from the previous step, so we are going to substitute here. So r of 1 2 to the power of 1 is nothing but 1 star 0, which is here. Then plus r of 1 2 to the power of 1 is again 1 star 0. R of 2 2 to the power of 1, r of 2 2 to the power of 1 is 0 plus 1 plus epsilon, so 0 plus 1 plus epsilon the whole star. Then again r of 2 2 to the power of 1 is going to be 0 plus 1 plus epsilon. So next we are going to simplify this. So 1 star 0, we'll keep it as it is, plus of 1 star 0. So these two expressions, since star is there, can be combined and written as 0 plus 1 plus epsilon the whole star, because 0 plus 1 plus epsilon whole thing can be included within 0 plus 1 plus epsilon. So once we have done this, we'll make the further substitution. We will simplify this further, so which is equal to 1 star 0 plus 1 star 0. So we'll see how to simplify this expression. So we have 0 plus 1 plus epsilon the whole star, okay? So therefore 0 plus 1 the whole star, we can also have epsilon included here. So because if you don't choose anything for this entire expression, epsilon is also included here, so therefore we can just write it as 0 plus 1 the whole star. So next, this is nothing but 1 star 0 plus 1 star 0 plus 0 plus 1 the whole star. So here 1 star 0, 1 star 0, so these two remain as common. So therefore we can just write it as 1 star 0 followed by 0 plus 1 the whole star. So how do we actually get this expression from this expression? So 1 star 0 and nothing else. So this is 1 star 0 or this much. So if I want only 1 star 0, I can get it with 1 star 0, and then this star can be 0 occurrences. So therefore this expression suffices this. In case we don't want this part and we want the or part, only so much, so that is also here, that is 1 star 0, 0 plus 1 whole star. So this is how we do the simplification, and this is the final regular expression that we need for the sum. We'll see whether the regular expression that we have obtained is actually the one which is accepted by this DFA. So what we can see here, it is accepting any number of 1s. So shall we write as 1 star followed by a 0. So it follows a 0. After that, any number of zeros or 1s can be accepted. So any number of zeros or 1s can be accepted. So this is the regular expression that we have framed from the Kleene's theorem. Okay, so therefore let's write few strings here. Let's take up 1 0 0 0. W2 is equal to 0 0 0. W3 is equal to 0 1 0. So let's see if all the strings are accepted by the DFA and accepted by the regular expression. So 1 followed by 000. So 1 0 0 0. Next 0 0 0 accepted. 0 1 0. So 0 1 0 accepted. So let's see if the same thing can be accepted here. So next we have 1. So here, from here we'll pick up 1. Next 0 we will pick up from here. Next there are 2 zeros. So here I'm imagining that it is 2. So first time I'm choosing 0, and for the second time also I'm choosing 0. So we are accepting the string 1 0 0 0. Next we have 0 0 0. So it is 1 star. So for this 1 star, I'm imagining that this is 0 occurrences of 1. So therefore this 0 I'll pick it up from here. Then I have 2 more zeros. So for these 2 more zeros, I will imagine that this is a 2 for this star. First time I'm going to pick up 0, even the second time I'm going to pick up 0. Next 0 1 0. So 1 star, I'm imagining that it is 0 occurrences of 1 star. So for star I'm substituting 0, so this 1 will never be considered. So the first 0 is actually got from here. Then I have 1. So 1 I'll pick from here, and then 0 I'll pick from here. Again this is 2 occurrences, 2 times I can pick. So first time I can pick either 0 or 1, or and also for the second time I can either pick 0 or pick 1. So this is how we verify whether the strings which are accepted by the DFA are the strings which are actually mentioned by the regular expression. So this is the end of the Kleene's theorem, and we'll have to be thorough with the simplification part of all the expressions.